Greetings, our Hebrew Israelite sisters and brothers. This is L.D. Smith, the watchman on the wall. Israel, it is our Sabbath. Grab that King James. Now, first and foremost, we want to wish all of our sisters and brothers all over happy Sabbath. Before we go into our teaching, we got a wonderful teaching tonight. All right? Now, going forward, most of you guys know that follow us, we disprove everything that comes out of Lucifer, a.k.a. Jesus' mouth. All right? And tonight going to be another night. Now, going forward, I want you to listen to what we're reading tonight, okay, my sisters and brothers? And most of all, I want you to think about it. You know, because in the end, it's going to be your decision, all right? But my goal is to prove to the world that Lucifer, a.k.a. Jesus, is nothing but a liar. Now, that being said, let's go forward because we're going to prove that he is not God, neither is he God's son. All right? Now, let's go. I always, Israel, say if you want the truth, you got to go back. Okay? So, we're going to go back to Genesis. We're going to start at Genesis, then we're going to go forward. Okay? Now, watch this right here. Let's go to Genesis chapter 1, verse 1. It says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. God, by himself. Nobody with him. God. Jesus is nowhere mentioned. All right? Now, let's go to the book of Deuteronomy. Let us turn the pages here a little bit. Let's go to the book of Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy 5. Let's go there. Like I say, I want you to read this and just think about what is transpiring here. Chapter 5 in the book of Deuteronomy. We're going to read verses 6, 7, 8, and 9. And see, God does not want us to worship another God. I mean, my sisters and brothers, we have to see it, you know, like the Bible says it. Everyone has a God but us. We have to have a God that doesn't look like us. We have to have a Savior that doesn't look like us. That's what they show us. But they're showing us a lie. All right? Now, I want you to think about that. If you look at all the different races on the planet, they all have their gods and their gods look like them. Why is it that we as black people, we have a white God? I mean, my sisters and brothers, red flags should go up somewhere. But anyway, we're going to go into the teaching and I'm going to hammer away at this false demigod. Now, let us go forward here. Chapter 5 in the book of Deuteronomy, let's look at verses 6, 7, 8, 9. It says, I am the Lord. See that? I am. Not nobody else. I am. When you say I am, that excludes everyone else. He said, I'm the Lord, thy God, which brought thee out of the land of Egypt from the house of bondage. Thou shalt have no other God before me. See, the very next thing he says is, Israel should not have another God besides him. But we got a God that we serve here in Western civilization called America that doesn't look anything like us. Not only that, he doesn't do a damn thing for us. And look what he said, thou shalt make thee any graven images of any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the waters beneath the earth. But yet, you see, we walk around with these little gold chain with the cross on it. Walk around with it with him on there. You know, that's a graven image. But anyway, he said, thou shalt not bow down thyself unto them, nor serve them, for I am the Lord thy God, am jealous, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children unto the third and fourth generation. That he says, of them that hate him. See, when you serve another God, you're showing God that you have no respect for him. You are disrespecting God. And that is the most horrible thing that you can do to God is go with someone else. I mean, think about it. If you are dating or married to an individual and you see them with somebody else, oh man, it's on. It's on. God said he's married to Israel. But anyway, my sisters and brothers, let's go a little further. Let's look at Exodus. Let's go back to the book of Exodus. All right, Exodus 23. Let's go there. Exodus 23. Let's look at verses 22 through 25. Look what it says. He says, But if thou shalt indeed obey his voice and do all that I speak, then I will be an enemy unto thine enemies and an adversary unto thine adversaries. For my angel shall go before thee and bring thee unto the Amorites, the Hittites, the Perizzites, the Canaanites, the Hivites, and the Jebusites, and I will cut them down. He says, thou shalt not bow down to their God. I mean, this is God is sending over and over and over and over again to his children that I do not want you to bow down to another God. I mean, it's so hard to convince blacks here in America that Jesus ain't shit, that Jesus hadn't done a damn thing for you, that Jesus is not God's son, that Jesus is not a God. Jesus isn't shit. As a matter of fact, he's less than shit. And you guys go and do all these different things in life, and then you come back and give him the credit for it. He hadn't done a damn thing. Let me say this in passing right here. Israel, think about this right here now. God, let's go back to Genesis. God told Moses that he'd be merciful unto who he want to be merciful to. Right or wrong? Right. Okay. Now, if you knew that was my MO, my means of operation, then there was a people that didn't know that those were my means of operation, I could trick them. I could trick them and make them think that I am responsible for all these things, good things that are happening in their life, and it can be further from the truth. And see, this is Lucifer. He knows how God operates. But like, if you go back to the beginning and read, you can see it. The Most High will show it to you that he is the one that have mercy and bless whoever he want to bless. And Jesus knows it. So but we come back over here in the New Testament, and then he make all these promises, but yet and still, God is the one that is doing it, and then you give him the fucking credit for it. I mean, it makes me so angry that you can't see it. I mean, it's right here in the pages, my sisters and brothers. And then they get here on this on YouTube and different different places and stuff and talk about Jesus this and Jesus that, my Lord and Savior. Listen, Jesus Christ is not your Lord and Savior, and he damn sure ain't he's not mine. And there's not a damn thing good I can say about Jesus. Nothing. And I will never bow down to him. Now, let's move forward here. Let's go to Exodus. Well, let's don't go there. Let's go to Isaiah 44. Watch it right here, my sisters and brothers. God hates it. God hates it. Isaiah 44. Watch this right here. God hates we bowing down to him, because God is the only true and living God. There is no other God. With a big G, there's a lot of little ones, but he is the ultimate God. He is God above gods. Now, Isaiah 44, let's look at verse 6. Look what it says here. It says, thus saith the Lord, the King of Israel, and his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts. I am the first and the last, and besides me, there is no God. Now, I don't give a damn what Jesus says in the New Testament about him being the first and the last. And that could be for the truth. And I'm going to prove it to you. I mean, it's very disturbing to me when my people seem like they just can't get it. I mean, we go over this over and over, proving to you over and over, Jesus ain't shit. Jesus is not your Savior. Jesus hadn't done a damn thing for you. And you get right back and start saying the same stupid ass shit all over and over again. Jesus does not care a damn thing about you. Neither has he done anything for you. The Most High have done everything for you. Now, let's go a little further. Let's look at Isaiah 44 and 8. Look what it says. Well, let's read 7 and 8. It says, and who as I shall call and shall declare it and set it in order for me, since I appointed the ancient people and the things that are coming and shall come, let them show unto them Now he said, fear ye not, neither be afraid. Have I not told thee from that time, and have declared it? Ye are even my witnesses. Is there a God besides me? No, ain't no God beside him. Yea, there is no God. I know not any. Now, my sister and brother, if Jesus came from the Most High, don't you think he would have mentioned him there? Jesus not even mentioned. But like I say, I'm going to go on down here and I'm going to prove to you over and over, Jesus has nothing to do with the Most High, neither the Hebrew Israelites. Now, let's go a little further. Let's go here to verse 24 here in Isaiah 44. Look what it says here. It says, thus saith the Lord, thy Redeemer, and he that formed thee from the womb. I am the Lord that maketh all things, that stretch forth the heavens alone. God said, I was by myself. Where is Jesus? Where is Jesus that he talks about over there in first in St. John, talking about everything was made by him and wasn't anything made without him? Where is he at? I keep on saying, if y'all go back, my sister and brother, if you go back, you will see that the New Testament is nothing but a bunch of bullshit. Now, God says, I've done this alone. He said, that spreadeth abroad the earth by myself. I mean, do we not understand Western civilization language? By myself means, wasn't nobody there with me. I did it by myself. What is so hard about that? I mean, we make it like seem like, oh, it's so hard. You know, they teaching all this stuff. This is not hard. All it is taking some time to look down and read it and then think about it. You won't even consider. Why? Because you have been so westernized with Western civilization and bullshit until can't get a word into your brain edgeways. Okay, let's go a little further. Let's go to Job. Watch it right here. Let's go to Job. Job chapter 9, verse 8. Where we can read 7 and 8. Job chapter 9, verse 7 and 8. It says, which commandeth the sun, and it rises not, and sealeth up the stars. Which alone, see that? Spread it out the heavens and tread it upon the waves of the sea. God say, I did this by myself. But now, we're going to show you here another scripture. Let's go back to Isaiah 42. Let's go there. Isaiah 42. Watch this. Isaiah 42. Isaiah 42, 5. Look what it says here. Thus saith the Lord God, he that created the heavens and stretched them out. He, see that? He, singular, that spreadeth forth the earth and that which cometh out of it. He, singular. See that? Wasn't nobody with him? He said, that giveth breath unto the people upon it and spirit to them that walk therein. He, singular. Not me and my father. He. And I'm going to deal with that me and my father bullshit too. Let's go forward here. Let's go to the book of John. Let's go to the book of John. John chapter 10. They call it St. John, but I don't see a damn thing saying about it. Nothing. John 10. Let's look at verse 30. It says, I and my father are one. That's what he says. He and God is one. That couldn't be farther from the truth. Now to prove it, let's look at something. Now, Jesus said that he and God is one. That he is like God and all this other bullshit, right? Now, isn't it in their writing, the New Testament, that Jesus was born by Mary. Mary was his mother, you know, and then they went into Egypt because the king was trying to kill him and all this other bullshit. Right? Okay, now, my question to you guys is this right here. I always say go back. Go back to the beginning and then you'll see that all this shit over here is nothing but shit. Okay? Now, he was supposed to be born and came down through a woman, didn't it? Right? Watch this right here. Okay, let's go to Genesis 18. Watch this. See, I told you to go back. We're going to go back. Genesis 18. Now watch this. Alright? You ready, Israel? Watch this. Genesis 18. Verse 1. And the Lord appeared unto him, who? Abraham. In the plains of Mamre. And he sat in the tent door in the heat of the day. And he lifted up his eyes and looked. And lo, three men stood by him. Now, if you finish reading the story, we see right now that God is one of these men. The Most High is one of these men. He have came into the form of a man, but he's not a man. But he's in the form of a man now. My question to anybody, why would he come in the form of a man over here and then come over here through a pregnancy? Does that make any sense at all? I mean, after all, he is God. He could just show up, right? Why did he have to come through a woman? He's already in the form of a man over here in Genesis. That makes no sense at all. But to make matters worse, let's go back to Job. Let's go to Job 14 and 1. Let's go to Job 14 and 1. Watch this right here. My sister and brother, watch this. We're going to go to Job chapter 14. Let's look at verse 4. Well, let's read from chapter verse 1 all the way down to verse 4, okay? That way we won't miss anything. It says, a man that is born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble. He cometh forth like a flower and is cut down. He fleeteth also as the shadow and continues not. He does thou open thine eyes upon such a one and bringeth me into judgment with thee. Now check this out right here. Who can bring a clean thing out of an unclean? Not one. See that? Now, if he's supposed to be this holy child, supposedly no sin at all, came from that which is filthy. How can a God come out of a filthy human? Supposedly. Because we are all filthy rags. Remember that now, huh? We are all unclean as filthy rags, right? Oh, yeah. But look, it gets even better. It says, seeing his days are determined. The number of his months are with thee. Thou hast appointed his bounds that he cannot pass. See that? See that? Jesus was a man. He ate food. He bled. He done all this. He did everything that a man does today. And yet he still died and said that he was a God. I mean, my sister and brother, how long are we going to be, you know, in this darkness that believing on this dim-ass God? But look here, I got something even better. Let's go to Job 25. Job 25, watch this right here. Job 25, verses, let's look at verses 4. Look what he says. How then can man be justified with God, or how can he be clean that is born of a woman? Now, my sisters and brothers, if y'all can't get that, something has to be wrong with your head. But yet, still, Jesus was so clean. He was so perfect. He never committed any sins. He kept the law. He did this. He broke every damn one of them. Not only that, he was a homosexual, a punk, a fag. That's what he was. And that's what he still is, because that's what he did. Now, how can he be God's son? It's right in the pages. I didn't make this up. How can you bring something pure out of something that is not pure? That's my question to all these Bible thumpers that love and running behind Jesus' faggot ass. That's my question. I mean, I am so fed up. I mean, I'm so tired of trying, you know, to convince individuals. I mean, I'm almost ready to throw my hands up. See, because the word can't lie. He said the secret things belong to the Lord, and those things that are revealed belong to the children. So if you don't get it, then it's your problem, not Hebrew. I mean, I have to go with the word. I can't go on my feelings. I can't go on what I may think. I got to go on the word. Either you're Hebrew or you're not. If you can't get this, then, baby, you're not Hebrew. You may want to be, but you're not. Now, let's go a little further here. Let's go to Isaiah. Let's go to Philippians. Let's go to Philippians 2. Let's go there. Philippians 2. Y'all know the scripture over there. Let's look at it. Philippians 2 and 6. He says, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation. Oh, really? He had 45,000 following behind him, 7,000. He had a fucking audience everywhere he went, but he made himself of no reputation, right? Couldn't be further from the truth. Look what he says here. But made himself no reputation and took upon the form of a servant and was made in the likeness of man. Now, my question is this right here. He had a fucking audience everywhere he went. Everywhere. Now, he's saying that he doesn't think that it is anything wrong with him being equal with God. That's what he says. So to be equal with someone is to be just like them, or to be them. But he says that he's equal with God. But let's just prove that, okay? All right, let's go to Isaiah 45. Isaiah 45. Isaiah 45, verse 1. Isaiah 45, verse 1. Is that the one I want? No, that's not the one I want. Let's go to Jeremiah. Jeremiah 10 and 6. Jeremiah 10. Jeremiah 10. Let's go there. Watch this right now, my sisters and brothers. Jeremiah 10, verse 6. It says, Jeremiah 10, verse 6 and 7. It says, for as much as there is none like unto thee, O Lord, thou art great, thy name is great and mighty. Who would not fear thee, all kings of nations? For to thee doeth it obtaineth for as much as among all wise men of nations and in all their kingdoms there is none like unto thee. Even back here, they always knew there's none like God. None like the Most High. Now let's go a little further here. Let's look at Isaiah 46. Isaiah 46. Let's go there. Isaiah 46. Let's look at that one. Isaiah 46 and 5. It says, to whom will ye liken me and make me equal and compare me that we may be alike? God said, ain't nobody like me. Ain't nobody like me. Jesus can say what he wants to say. God said, there is a nobody like me. Let's look at Isaiah 40. Let's back up. Isaiah 40. Isaiah 40 and 18. To whom then will ye liken God? Or what likeness will ye compare unto him? In other words, who or what can you compare to him to make them be like God? Nobody. Nowhere. Let's look at Isaiah 40, 25. He says again, to whom then will ye liken me or shall be equal, saith the Holy One? Nobody. I can answer nobody. 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 Now, Jesus here said, let's go to John. Over here in his gospel. John 3:16. John 3:15, whatever it is. Let's look at that real quick. See, because the Christians are hoping in vain. They're hoping in vain. Because you don't have a Savior. John 3:15. Let's look at this. Now, he making all these claims. Look what he says in 15. That whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might, but that the world through him might be saved. It couldn't be further from the truth. God never sent him. God kicked his ass out. That's what happened. God kicked his ass out. But God never sent Jesus to save anybody. Now, to prove that, Israel, you have to look at what God says about you. Now, Jesus, Paul and Jesus and all them say in Romans 10:9, that thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, thou shalt be saved. And whosoever call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. That's Romans 10:13 and all down through the nothing but a bunch of bullshit. Now, let us go here a little further. Let us look at Isaiah 43:11. Watch it right here. Isaiah 43:11. Watch this. Isaiah 43:11 says, I am the Lord, and besides me there is no Savior. There is no Savior. You Christians, you're hoping in Jesus, you don't have a Savior. The Most High, the Mighty One of Jacob, he is the only Savior. Nobody else. Nobody else. I'm telling you, he is right in the pages. Nobody else is a Savior. Let's look at Isaiah 43:3. Look what he says here. For I am the Lord thy God, the Holy One of Israel, thy Savior. See that? Thy Savior. He goes on here. But we can go on and on. Let's look at Isaiah 45:21-22. He says, assemble yourselves and come, draw nigh together, ye that are escaped of the nation. They have no knowledge that set up the wooden of their graven images and pray unto a God that cannot save. He said, tell ye and bring them near. Ye, let them take counsel together. Who hath declared it from ancient time? See that? Ancient time. Ancient time. This didn't start yesterday. This went way back. God has always been the only Savior. Always. From the very beginning, he was the only Savior. Nobody else. But yet and still, Lucifer comes over in the New Testament and tell these damn lies to my sister and brother, and then tell him that he's a Savior, and he's not. Now look what he says here. Latter part of verse 21, he says, who has told it from that time, have not I the Lord? God says, I've been telling you this same thing from day one that I created man, that I am the only Savior. I am the only true and living God. There's no other God beside me that can save. He said, this ain't just started. I've been saying the same thing, and it will never change. And look what he says here. He says, I the Lord, there is no God else beside me. A just God and a Savior. There is none besides me. How much more does one have to keep on arguing with you and trying to get you to believe? He said, look unto me. Look unto me. Look unto me. Not unto Jesus. Look unto me and be ye saved, all the ends of the earth. For I am God and there is none else. In the story. Why can't you understand that, Israel? Y'all need to bring your ass out of Lucifer's house. He is not a Savior. Now, let's go a little further. Let's look at Jeremiah. Let's go to Jeremiah here. Jeremiah 2:3. Jeremiah 2. Let's go there. Jeremiah 2. verse 3. Look what he says. Israel was holy unto the Lord and fruitful of his increase. All that devour him shall often evil shall come upon them. Is that what I want? No. I'm sorry, my sister and brother. I want Jeremiah 3 and 23. That's what I want. 3 and 23. Watch the rest of my sisters and brothers. We're going to start with verse 20, 21. Jeremiah 3, verse 21, 22, and 23. That's what I want. A voice was heard upon the high places, weeping and supplication of the children of Israel, for they have perverted their ways, and they have forgotten the Lord their God. Return, ye backsliding children, and I will heal your backsliding. Behold, we come unto thee, for thou art the Lord our God. Now look what he says. Truly, in vain is salvation hope from the hills and from the multitude of mountains. Truly, in the Lord God is their salvation of Israel. Nowhere else. My sisters and brothers, you're not going to get salvation any other place but in the Most High. So why are you continually going back and forth into Lucifer's house? I mean, just something has to be wrong with your head. Now we're going to do a few more scriptures to prove to you that he is only one God. Now let's look at 1 Kings. 1 Kings 8, 60. 1 Kings. 1 Kings. Let's go there. 1 Kings 8, chapter 8, verse 60. Look what it says here. He said, that all the people of the earth may know that the Lord is God and there is none else. See that? All back here, all in the Kings. I mean, the only place where this bullshit comes up is the New Testament. Everybody back here knew that there was only one God. And that's why when Lucifer showed up, they asked him, well, who are you? Elias? You know, figuring, you know, Elijah? Because God said he was going to send back Elijah. He never said he was going to send Jesus. Never. Nobody can show me any place in the Old Testament where God said he was going to send Jesus. I don't want to hear about no Messiah. I don't want to hear none of the other bullshit. You show me where he says he was going to send Jesus. And all these names start changing and shit. You know what? We're going to make it fit. No, you're not going to make it fit. You show me where he said he going to send Jose. I mean, whatever his name is. Jesus. Lucifer, a.k.a. Jesus. Show me where he said he was going to send him. He said he was going to send back Elijah the prophet. That's what he said to Israel. Now let's go a little further here. 2 Kings. Let's go to 2 Kings 19. 2 Kings 19. Watch this right here, my sister and brother. 2 Kings 19, 15. Look what he says. And Hezekiah prayed before the Lord and said, O Lord God of Israel, which dwelleth between the cherubim, that thou art the God, even thou alone of all the kingdoms of the earth. Thou hast made heaven and earth alone. Alone. Everybody knew it back in those days. Why can't we see it in this day? Why is it so hard for us to see it in this day? Everybody back in the Old Testament knew that God was the only God. I mean, my sisters and brothers, it is frustrating to see our people so ignorant. Now let's look at another. Let's go to Zechariah. Zechariah, watch it right here. Let's go to Zechariah. Zechariah 14. 14:9. Look what it says here. And the Lord shall be king over all the earth. In that day shall there be one Lord, and his name one. Where is Jesus? I mean, in the Baptist churches, in these other churches, they got one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. I mean, well, if that's the case about the one baptism, why does Paul talk about the first baptism was when they came through the Red Sea? Over there in, I think it's second Corinthians, the 10th chapter, somewhere along in there. I can't just call it up because I hadn't been over there in a while. But anyway, how can that be? It doesn't make sense to me. Now let's go a little further. Let's go to Hosea. Let's go to Hosea here. Hosea 13 and 4. Look what it says. Yet I am the Lord thy God from the land of Yet I am the Lord thy God from the land of Egypt, and thou shalt know no God but me. For there is no Savior beside me. Everybody knew it back there. But when we come to the New Testament, I mean, we just refuse to listen. We refuse to accept the truth. I mean, my sisters and brothers that are still in Lucifer's house, Jesus is going to be your destruction. I mean, honestly, I mean, I can't say it any plainer. I mean, I have a job that has been, you know, given to me in order to warn my sisters and brothers. But, I mean, we are the most stiff-necked people. We are, I'm not going to go that route. Jesus is my Lord and Savior. And the thing about it is, he keeps you hanging on. He keeps dragging you on. You got to do this. Then once you do that, you got to do this. I mean, just keeps dragging you on and on and on. There's no end to his bullshit. And you've been there 30, 40, 50, 60 years. Die in that bullshit and never get any of the things that he promised you. Nothing. But yet it's still, Jesus is my Lord and Savior, and I love Jesus. But you're going to die. I promise you that. If you don't change your ways, you Christians, and that may be Hebrew, I'm talking to the ones that might be Hebrew. If you don't change your ways, you're going to die. And I guarantee you that. Now we're going to look at one more here. Let us look at Isaiah 46 and 10. Let us look at that. Isaiah 46 and 10. I think we already did them, but let's look at it again. Isaiah 46 and 10. Look what it says here, my sisters and brothers. Look what it says. Isaiah 46, 9 and 10. It says, remember the former things of old. If you want to know the truth, you got to go back to the beginning. You are not going to get the truth starting at the beginning of another book, the New Testament. You got to go back to the beginning of the Old Testament, and you'll find out the truth. Look what he says. Remember the former things of old, for I am God, and there is none else besides. There is none else. I keep on saying over and over, everyone knew, even the strangers, even the ones that wasn't the Hebrew Israelites, they knew that the Hebrew Israelite God was God. Now, why we can't get it over the New Testament, I have no idea. But anyway, let's go on. He says, I am God and there is none like me, including Jesus. There's none like me. He said, declaring the end from the beginning. My sisters and brothers, are you hearing? He said, declaring the end from the beginning. Do you want to know what the end is? You got to go back to the beginning. And he said, I've been telling you from the beginning, I am the only God. It's right in the pages. Look what he said. He said, remember the former things of old. Old is back to the beginning. He said, for I am God and there is none else. I am God and there is no God like me. Then he says, I've been telling you the same thing. He said, declaring the end from the beginning. If you want to know the end, you got to go back to the beginning. He said, and from ancient time, way back, things that are not yet done, saying, my counsel shall stand. What I say is not going to change. Look what he says here. And I will do all my pleasure. My sisters and brothers, God going to do whatever he wants to do. So if you want to continue to believe in Jesus, you're on your own. I've shown you multiple times that Jesus is not God's son. Jesus is not a savior. Jesus ain't shit. As a matter of fact, he's less than shit. There's nothing good that I can ever say about Jesus. Now, my sisters and brothers, we here at LieToMeNoMore.org. We wish you a happy Sabbath. Until next time, shalom.